What's going on in Philadelphia right now? Everybody who's watching right now, I think we're all very aware of the situation as it continues to develop. In case you're not, we'll just get you updated on everything going on with Ben Simmons and the Sixers. Shouts out to Sham. This tweet comes in. Ben Simmons currently not mentally ready to play for the team and was receiving treatment on his back today due to ramp up process. He will miss Friday's home opener against the Nets and is not expected to play for an undetermined period of time. A lot to unravel there. We know he's been a major distraction so far, has been fined a lot of money, has yet to engage in team practice, and he was already suspended one game. At this point, and this is just me personally, I don't see a way where he can ever play for the Sixers ever again. Your thoughts?
Well, I think it's going to be very hard for Ben Simmons to play for the Sixers because, first of all, the fan base is totally turned on him. His teammates now don't want him there, so they're going to have to get this deal done. But the problem is, the 76ers organization, they're charging teams the same prices as when they got him the first year when he was the number one pick, or when they gave him the $140 million or whatever the contract is. They're trying to get that type of value back, but Ben Simmons is no longer viewed as that type of player. As your boy, the great philosopher Fat Joe likes to say, yesterday's prices are not today's prices. Exactly. And so that's part of the problem is that Ben Simmons was once the number one pick. He was an incredible talent, incredibly, incredibly good on the defensive end. But teams know that, hey, this guy not only doesn't shoot the ball well, but is sometimes afraid to shoot. So that is where the dynamic comes in. How do they're trying to get prices from 2 to 3 years ago, and they're trying to apply that to today. It's not really going to work. I think the 76ers are going to have to lower their asking price, and maybe they do a deal with somebody like the Sacramento Kings. They're trying to get rid of Marvin Bagley and maybe like Buddy Hield, something like that. But I don't think they're going to get the haul that they once thought they were.
No question. He is a skilled basketball player. We know he's been an all-star multiple times. However, there are some liabilities on the offensive end that are glaring, and we saw them develop in the playoffs last year. And we got tweet ins because apparently Daryl Morey has been speaking. So this is the tweet coming in from Chris Mannix. Philadelphia radio interview confirming what's been widely believed. He will not be pressured into trading Ben Simmons. Quote, people should buckle in. This is going to take a long time.
Oh, that ain't people. that ain't people. Hey, listen.
Who is
that,
it then?
He is talking directly to Rich Paul and Clutch Sports. Mm. Buckle in. You're going to be in for a long ride. You thought you were going to bully us into a deal, but we will move on this process when we think it's good for us. So that tweet wasn't meant for me, wasn't meant for you, wasn't meant for my mama. That tweet was meant for Rich Paul and Clutch Sports, letting those guys know, oh, if you think you guys are going to come up here and just disrupt things and we're going to get Ben out of here as soon as he wants to, no, we're not going to do that. So I see what Daryl Morey is trying to do, but I don't see how this ends well for the 76ers. I think at the end of the day, they're going to have to take a below market value for Ben Simmons to get him out of there.